Jenny is up. What's up, buddy? He's here often. He says, hello, fellow hump dayers. Hope everyone is super excellent. Quick question. With all the GDPR craziness, do we need to be applying this to our local lead gen sites? We operate in home repair niche in Florida, and our customers come from a couple other states, people with vacation homes. Thoughts? Chris and Hernan and Adam are the ones to answer that. I've done nothing with that. So what do you guys say?
Yeah. And if I might, and there's a lot of debate still on the GDPR side of things. And then there's Chris saying you hi with the wig and, you know, saying you cheers and whatnot on the Bradley screen. So that's his response. But in short, what you need to do is that, just to put it, we're not lawyers. I'm not a lawyer. So you need to have that in mind. But what we found is that you need to make people aware that if you're giving them something, you need to have their express consent for them, for you to market them something else, right? So for example, let's say that you're giving away something for free, like a free, I don't know, teeth whitening or something like that, right? To sweeten the deal. And you want to add a checkbox on whatever it is that you're doing, ClickFunnels or whatever. You want to add a checkbox over there that says, I also want to get marketing or promotional material from this company. You know, that's basically it. That's basically all you need to do right now to get to be compliant. With that said, there's a lot of still of debate going on, and personally, and this is 100% a personal opinion, don't take it as advice. I think that they're gonna go for the big dogs first, because if you're just conducting normal business and getting, I don't know, a handful of leads, maybe, I don't know, 200 leads a month or something like that, you're not even, you know, you're not even a target. So they're gonna be going after the big lead gen companies and everything like that before going, and then we will see how that develops before being, you know, completely structured on what we need to be doing in terms of GDPR. What do you think, Adam?
Yeah, I think too, the thing to keep in mind with this is, you know, hey, do the right thing. If you're doing something shady, if you're not saying people, telling people you're gonna send them emails, things like that, you know, get that stuff in order. But the main thrust, at least as again, as I understood it, because there's a lot of interpretation here of GDPR, is to deal with data storage and privacy. And I realize on the sharp end of the stick for us, that usually comes down to how you handle emails. GDPR was not created to deal with people's lead magnet funnels or things like that. It's more about, you know, what are you doing with that information? Can people get that information? Can they delete it from your systems? That's what it's more about. So just keep that in mind. But I agree with what Hernan was saying.
Yeah, so my only advice would be, like, for example, I don't know how to apply this yet, Jenia, to local stuff. I don't know where we need to apply it or when or how. So I'm just kind of waiting to let some of the dust settle and let the big guys figure it out. And then it'll trickle on down to the little old me. You know what I mean? So that's basically what why I don't have an answer for you on that. I know it's something that I will also need to be concerned about, being in the local lead gen space as well. But it's not something that I'm going to worry about it currently, when it's still like a bunch of craziness, as you mentioned in your comment, because it really truly is. It's real foggy. It's murky right now. I don't know of anybody that knows all the answers yet, but in time it will work itself out, and then I'll start to implement whatever I need to at that point. But I'm not really super concerned at the moment, because I don't do anything super spammy to email subscribers, at least not for local stuff, right? Anyways, that's my thought on it.
Yeah, and I totally agree with you, Bradley. But one more thing that you need to have in mind is that whatever you're using, whatever tools that you're using to collect your emails, you know, we usually go with Drip. On, you know, Bradley's case, we use ActiveCampaign, we use ClickFunnels and whatnot. You need to make sure that whatever you're using, they are GDPR compliant, you know? So that's up to you as a data manager to make sure that everyone that you're using, every, you know, service provider, your email autoresponder, your landing page builder, whatever you're doing, is GDPR compliant. The good news is that most of the stuff, if not all of the stuff that we teach you guys, or that we recommend, like ClickFunnels, Thrive, ActiveCampaign, Drip, you know, the biggest tools out there, they're already compliant with GDPR. So there's not a big deal over there. But if you have questions about this and that provider, you can always reach out to them and tell them, hey guys, are you GDPR compliant? Because most of the big companies, they have already done their homework, because those are going to be the big targets, you know,
right?
Not the not like not the small guy, but for example, ActiveCampaign, you know, those that are handling, or ClickFunnels that are handling millions of emails per month, pretty much. So.
All right. So if I can just clarify a point, because he's asking a local lead gen site in Florida. The European Union cannot enforce a European law on U.S. soil unless you're targeting European Union members. And so as long as you're just within Florida and you have a lead, or within the U.S., you could even go as far Latin America. There is no GDPR law in Latin America. And so you could target that. At the moment that you start getting people from the EU for whatever reason, I don't see why you would in Florida, why someone in Germany would want your services in Florida, since you're local. You can't go to Germany and service whatever it is that they want, or France or whatever. Local, it doesn't apply. You're within the U.S. You're bound by U.S. laws, not European Union. Now, as far as Semantic Mastery, it's a global company. We accept people from all over the world, including the European Union, and so we have to abide by GDPR. And that's the distinct difference. It's whether it's within the boundaries of the European Union, or if you're doing financial transactions, even if you're outside the European Union, you have to provide GDPR protection to that information. So I hope that clarifies it a little bit.
Yeah, I totally agree with Marco as well. I do see this as an effort, you know, or, you know, when you, like, even if you're not reach out, because I totally agree with Marco, what Marco is saying in terms of if you're doing business in South Florida or something like that, you are technically not reached by the GDPR. But I do think that not yet, but Facebook, AdWords, et cetera, as they are asking you to have, you know, their privacy policy, et cetera, on the footer to make your ads compliant and whatnot, they're going to start enforcing that. There's not happening that yet, as of yet, but I think that at some point that's coming, and it has to do with, you know, being able to advertise on these platforms that we know that we're doing in terms of Facebook or AdWords. We need to be compliant because, as Marco was saying, we get a lot of leads and a lot of people from Europe, but it's coming at some point, so I think it's better to be prepared.
I agree.